Our next guest is a good friend of ours. He actually came on a free one-day training that myself and my father ran many years ago now. It was one day. Within about 3 or 4 weeks, he was on television hypnotizing somebody to great effect, which got my interest. And I'm pleased to say that we've been in touch and sharing ideas ever since. I'm not going to say anything more other than that he is a professional mind reader. He's travelled all the way from Vienna, Austria, to be with us today, and I hope you saved your biggest round of applause for last. Please welcome Harry Lucas.
Thank you so very much. Before we start, everyone, would you please stand up? Raise your right hand and speak after me. Hereby I promise. Publicly and solemnly, that I've prearranged nothing with Harry Lucas. That's me. That I'm not an actor or stooge. And I would never say something just because a stranger tells me to. Which you just did. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. It's such an honor to be here with you. And I'd like to say thank you to Anthony and Kev and the whole head-hacking team for putting this together. It's been a phenomenal day so far, and I've learned so much. I'd like to say thank you very much. This is absolutely brilliant. Today I'd like to talk with you about my use and understanding of hypnosis, the challenges I faced along the way, and the visions that I had for myself, where I wanted to go, how I achieved these goals, and at the very end of my talk, I'd like to tell you about my most unusual experience, which changed my view of hypnosis completely. But I could talk the whole day, but I think it's much more impressive for you if we just did something. And I'd like to use someone who has a quite good imagination. Let's see. You just smile at me now. I would love to do this with you, if I may. Yeah? Hello, I'm Harry. You are?
Claire,
would you come up and give her a big round of applause? Claire, everyone. Claire, would you stand here? Claire, we haven't been hypnotized before.
Not by you,
no. No, okay, very good. Thank you so much for doing this. Look at your hand, and close your eyes, and sleep deeper, deeper down, all the way down, all the way deep. I'm not really hypnotizing you right now, but all I want you to do, and what I want us to do, is just to synchronize our minds so that you think the same things as I do. And because you see, as a professional performer, I do get the chance to travel quite a bit. And when I think of all the journeys that I've done, all the destinations I've been to, I can see lots of pictures in my mind. And if it's really true what I'm saying, and if this is really working, by now you should have seen some of those images as well, some of those journeys. Is that correct? Very good. I want you to select one of these images. That's the one. And I want you to make it as bright and vivid as you possibly can. Turn up the contrast. Double the size of it. And again, and again. And then step inside that picture. So, as if it was that you were living in my memory. Does that make sense? Okay. Good. Obviously, I'm traveling. And just take a look around. Can you guess in what kind of, in what part of the world and what continent I'm in? Did it again? Japan. Okay, very good. Very good. Now I've traveled through Japan quite a bit. And I've done some sightseeing there as well. And I've seen lots of those sites, but one stood out in particular. And it stood out because of a very specific color. And as you look at that picture now, can you guess what color that is? Golden. And as you take a step back from that golden thing, can you guess what kind of image that is? What am I looking at? Say it again. A temple, that's right. And there was something else that I did. It was kind of funny for me, and it must have been funny for the others to look at as well. And as you look at me doing that right now, what do you think I did then?
Wrestling?
Sumo wrestling. That is exactly right. And in a few moments, all those images will get blurry and more distant. You can just allow yourself to come back and reorientate yourself to the room. Claire, did you really see those pictures? Yeah? Thank you so much. Give Claire a big round of applause. When I started, it was highly unusual for me to even get involved in this whole business, in this whole kind of area, like hypnosis, because when I started, I was like 20 years old, and even before, I've heard about hypnosis, obviously, but it was highly unlikely for me to get involved in this kind of thing, because the image that I had in mind was not a very appealing one. The image of a hypnotist was, that there was a sleazy guy performing in a crowded bar in front of drunk people making fun of them. And although this may be very funny to watch, I did not see myself in that role. So it was not a very appealing one. I didn't want to become that hypnotist. When I was about 20 years old, I was on an NLP weekend seminar, and I got introduced to the idea of eye movement and the idea that you can so-called manipulate people just by talking to them. And that was kind of interesting to me. But at the same time, a friend of mine started those NLP courses full-time, and he was starting to act quite weirdly. Because every time we talked, he would go, mm-hmm, as if he understood exactly what I was going to say, and he was starting to mirror me. And I thought, okay, I don't know if that is the kind of thing that I'd like to do. Later on, he became quite normal again, but I think it was just the very first step, his first steps of NLP. Then, at this course, of course, the names of Bandler and Grinder got mentioned, and I took a look at their books as well, and I started to study Erikson, and because a friend of mine suggested get his books, and I got the collected books of Erikson. It was like full detail, 6 books this thick, and the problem I had with that was that it was so much detail that I didn't know where to start. As a beginner, I didn't know where to start, how to get my head around. So I thought, perhaps therapy is not the right choice for me anyway. Perhaps stage hypnosis would be an interesting starting point for me. So I got the book of the guru of stage hypnosis, which is Ormond McGill's book. And again, it's this thick, and I studied it, and the problem that I had with that was that if you do a stage hypnosis show, you have a stage here, and you have like 20 chairs, and people expect to be hypnotized. They come to the show and they want to be hypnotized. I didn't want to do a stage hypnosis show. I didn't have the luxury of a stage. So how do you start? Again, it was that point. I didn't know where to start. And so a couple of years ago, I got in touch with Anthony Chaquin and Freddie Chaquin, and we trained in this one-day course. And all of a sudden, I got a starting point. I knew how to start. It was do this, do that, and after that you do this and this. And it got me started. So after those many years, finally, I had taken the first step into hypnosis. And as Anthony said, a couple of weeks later, I was on TV. We were given, when I say we, it was myself and three of some very good friends. We have a group of magicians called the Magic Mushrooms. And it's a name you will remember. Somehow it sticks, I don't know. And we had our own TV series. And I had some crazy ideas for this TV series. And let's see how that works. The laptop and...
Katja, wie mit allen Zuschauerinnen und Zuschauern, die bei uns mitmachen, muss ich auch dich fragen, wir haben nichts abgemacht, du bist keine Eingeweihte, keine Schauspielerin. Dann. Gut, dann habe ich etwas für dich, ja, was gleich Bedeutung haben wird. Ich gebe es dir und wir gehen jetzt mal in den Kinosaal.
Okay.
Bist du ein Kinofan?
Ja.
Schaust du dir gerne Filme an?
Eigentlich schon, ja.
Katja, wir stehen vor einem leeren Kinosaal.
Ja.
Und ich möchte, dass du dir jetzt einen Platz aussuchst.
Okay. Warum soll ich mich hinsetzen, oder?
Wenn du dir schon einen ausgesucht hast.
Ja?
Gerne. Dann stell dir mal vor, der Vorhang geht auf,
ja,
der Film beginnt. Mach mal die Augen zu, ich möchte, dass du das nur in deinen Gedanken machst. Und stell dir vor, während der Film beginnt, erscheint ein Gesicht. Es ist zuerst unscharf, aber plötzlich wird es scharf und klarer.
Mhm.
Kannst du mir sagen, ist das ein Herr oder eine Dame?
Das ist ein Herr.
Das ist ein Herr. Und wenn du ein bisschen zurückzoomst und ein bisschen mehr von dem Film, von der Umgebung siehst.
Mhm.
Was macht dieser Herr gerade?
Vieles. Im Moment fährt er gerade mit dem Auto.
Er fährt gerade mit dem Auto?
Ja.
Und kannst du diese Person genauer beschreiben, diesen Herrn, den du gerade Auto fahren siehst?
Der hat einen Hut auf.
Mhm.
Und er ist braun gebrannt, er ist ein Europäer und er hat so ein Safari-Outfit, so ein khaki-farbenes.
Das ist jetzt wahrscheinlich schwierig, aber wenn du dem Herrn einen Namen geben müsstest?
Ja, ich meine, er hat ja eh einen konkreten Namen. Das ist Indiana Jones.
Indiana Jones?
Ja.
Dann mach wieder die Augen auf. Du kannst dich erinnern, ich habe dir vorher ein Kuvert gegeben.
Ja.
Mach mal auf. Halt's ein bisschen höher. Mach mal auf. Schau, was da drin ist. Und halt's in die Kamera. Kannst du mir sagen, in welcher Reihe wir jetzt sitzen? Also wenn du jetzt einfach mal zählst, in welcher Reihe wir sitzen, kannst du mal zählen?
8.
In der Reihe 8.
Ja.
Und auf welchem Sitz sitzt du?
Nummer 7.
Nummer 7.
Okay.
Halt noch
echt. Ja. Das ist schon sehr beängstigend.
This gave me a starting point when I trained with Freddie and Anthony. But I thought, you know, what can you do better? What if you perform in front of an audience and they do not come to a hypnosis show, but you still want to use or show some of those phenomena, how can you get there? And at that time, a DVD and a CD popped up by a gentleman called James Tripp. Hypnosis without trance, and I do remember very vividly my first experience when I used hypnosis without trance. Just imagine, as you put those your hand up there, and it's stuck. And I remember the adrenaline rushing through my body because I couldn't believe it. But on the outside, I had to stay calm and act as if I've done that for thousands of times, of course. But inside, I was beaming with excitement. I was on cloud number 9, that this hand didn't move. Because, you know, when you're coming from a magic background, there are some instructions, and you do this, and then there's a gimmick or some secret stuff that you do, and it will work, and the audience will be amazed. But if your technique is just language, what if it doesn't? What if it just doesn't work? So that was kind of the a thought that held me back for quite some time, but fortunately I took the plunge and it worked perfectly at that time. And after that, I started to think about a stage show, because after the TV series, we had the opportunity to work in a theater for over 2 years, doing 2 shows. And in the second show, I wanted to do something with hypnosis. But not really hypnosis. I wanted to present, as I said, some phenomena. That I wanted to present amnesia, and that somebody's stuck to the table, which is an astonishing thing, especially if you're not in a hypnosis show. But I didn't have time for a 20-minute talk about hypnosis. I didn't have time for induction. I didn't want to say sleep. I didn't want to say deeper and deeper, and all these traditional thoughts. I didn't want to do that. So I got in touch with Anthony and Kev again, and we had a discussion and a theory that they had, which was, at that time, which was automatic imagination. And this is, for me, this is gold. This is something that you can do, as you've seen with Marcus. Just walk up to somebody and immediately you have an effect. There is no induction, there is nothing. It's just imagine. And I think, for me, as a mystery entertainer, it's much more appealing, and I think to the audience as well, because it's so quick. You know, it looks like magic. We're just talking, you're not hypnotized, there is no explanation. We're just talking, right? And you can stop imagining whenever you want to. That's it. So that was my great breakthrough. But something that I have learned from hypnosis as well is to look really closely. And I'd like to borrow a lady now. It's you. Would you mind coming up? Thank you so much. Big hand for Jenny. Jenny, do you know cards by any chance? Yes? A little, very good. We're going to use them because of different ones, and I don't want to get into your personal life now. Perhaps later on, but not now, okay? Jenny, what I want you to do is just pick a card and think of it, okay? And in a room full of hypnotists, this will be very easy for you, because what I want you to do is just watch Jenny's face, because somehow she will reveal herself, she will reveal her thoughts, okay? Try not to. Okay, whatever you want. Doesn't matter. Okay? Just take it. And what I want you to do is just have a clear picture in your mind of that card. Have you done that? Good. Very good. And would you please face the audience? Thank you so much. And could you imagine, just at the back of it, there is a big screen, like an IMAX movie screen? Yes? And just project the color to it. Is it a red or a black card? Okay? No, don't say it, just think. Otherwise we would have a different phenomenon, which is called hearing. It's not mind reading, but thank you so much. Okay, just focus. Is it a red or a black? It was very clear. Now, did you see it? You should blink the red. Here's a red card, yes? Very good. You're very good at that. Somehow it's our unconscious that does the movements, but it's okay. Just think of the shape of it, of the card now, yes? So we know it's a red one, so it can only be a heart or a diamond. And you're just nodding your head, a diamond, thank you so much. It's a diamond? Okay. Don't try not to give anything away, okay? But, good. We know it's a diamond. The next question I need to ask you, is it a number or a court card? Okay, so I guess it's not a court card because you blinked at numbers. Is that correct? Yeah, which makes it much more difficult because we have a lot more number cards than court cards. Thank you for doing that. Okay. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to count from ace to 10. And when you hear your value, the value of the card, yeah, just think stop in your mind, will you? Okay? Ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It was quite unclear, I would say. So let's really think stop loudly, okay?
Good.
Ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. I don't know if you have seen that, but I would guess you were looking very intently at that, yes? And that's a sign for somebody who concentrates quite a bit, which would mean it's one of the upper cards, 8, 9, or 10. Does it make sense? Okay, good. 8, 9, or 10. 8, 9, or 10. Just give me something. Thank you. It's a 10. 10 of diamonds? Show it to everyone. The 10 of diamonds, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. So, yeah, that's the things that I did on stage. But a couple of years ago, when I found out that my voice was not that good and I would get hoarse, especially in close-up gigs, which is when you walk from table to table at noisy events. And I would get hoarse quite easily, so I started to take voice lessons. And one side effect of those voice lessons after I finished the course was that we were starting to do acting exercises, I would say. And we were doing some exercises which helped me to get into the performance mode. And I found them very, very valuable because they put me where I needed to be in front of an audience. I needed to be in the moment. Don't worry about what happened or what might happen the next day. Just be at that very spot, at that very moment. And if you like, I'm going to show you one exercise that you can do. Are you happy to do that? Good. Yeah. What I want you to do is just put your feet flat on the floor. And put your hands on your lap, close your eyes. I'm not going to hypnotize you. This is, close your eyes and just become aware of those eyes as they float in their sockets, surrounded by the fluids. And what I want you to do is just relax those muscles around those eyes. And relax those muscles around the nose, around your brows, your temples, and your mouth. And as you relax all those muscles, I want you to think of those eyes as they float in those sockets, quite comfortably and easily. And I want you to take your attention and put it at the very center of those eyes. You don't need to do anything, just put the center of your the attention of in at the center of your eyes. And now take this attention and shift it to the very back of your eyes. And just notice how it feels. Now take this attention and put it to the very top of your eyes. Now focus on the very bottom of your eyes. And now take this attention and put it to the outer sides of your eyes. Not the inner ones, but the outer sides. And back to the center. And when whenever you feel like to, just open your eyes again and reorientate yourself back to the room. Very good. What that does for me is it just puts me into the moment. It's grounding me. It focuses me and it gets me where I need to be quite quickly. So if you are stressed, this would be an exercise that you can use just to focus again and de-stress yourself. Or if you have problems at night and you want to sleep and you can't sleep because a lot of thoughts are racing through your mind, you can use that as well. It helped me quite a bit. But there was one thing that was really, really remarkable. Because a couple of months later on, we were doing some method acting exercises, which are exercises which help you to get into a role, but also exercises which help you to prepare as an actor. And it uses some interesting exercises. And we don't have time to go through all those exercises now because this would take so long, but I'm going to tell you about it. And one of those exercises where we always started was called an overall exercise. And this is an exercise where you just stand in the room and with your eyes open. You're not hypnotized, you don't do anything, but it's just an imagination exercise. And you think, you imagine that there is a sun somewhere in the room or outside the room, it doesn't matter. But the beams of the sun are shining on you. And as you move your hands around, just notice where the beams of the sun are touching your body. And as you move your body in ways that you normally would not move, which is very important. And you do that for like 10 minutes, 15 minutes. And after that, or additionally, you do something else. You take a personal object, which is also imagined. An imagined favorite personal object that you hold in your hand, and you put it from one hand to the other, and then you let it touch your body in different places, as you imagine the sun coming, shining on you. So you have the sun and the personal object on you. And then my coach said, now I want you to go into a personal room. It can be anywhere. But if this room has walls, go to the walls and take a look what color this wall would be. And as I did this exercise, all of a sudden, a black wall shot up next to me, which was kind of scary because what does a black wall do next to me? I don't know. But she said, go there and touch it and feel what kind of texture it is made out of. And it was a leathery kind of, you know, the sofas with the big buttons. Yeah. Very strange indeed. And then she said, look around. And there was a small table standing next to me. And as I turned, a stop sign shot up in front of me. And I thought, that's weird. Stop sign. But hang on, I don't want to stop, I want to continue. And all of a sudden the stop sign changed into a green light. I said, that's okay. And then I continued, and all of a sudden I was standing in a theater, and thousand people looking at me. And I said, no, this is a private moment, go away, and vanished. And then I remembered an exercise we did quite earlier, which was walking on grass. So I imagined that it was grass all over the place, and I walked barefoot on the grass. And I thought, you know what, a river would be nice. So all of a sudden a river appeared, and I put my bare feet in the clear, ice-cold water. And then I thought, you know what? This has been a wonderful, incredible experience for me. Let's stop this. And it stopped. And everything vanished, and I knew it was hallucinating. I knew this was not real, but at the same time, it was real. And Ant and myself, we talked about this experience. It was as if those things were transparent. Not really there, but they were as real as I think hallucinations can get. So that changed my perception of hypnosis completely, because I was in there was no hypnosis context. I wasn't hypnotized by anybody. There was no induction, there was no sleep, there was no deeper and deeper, and yet I experienced some heavy phenomenon, as they were described in the literature. Because if you hallucinate, you have to be very deep, and I wasn't anywhere. I was just imagining. I'd like to use the lady who's writing things down right at the moment. Yes, it is you. Yes, me. Hello. Would you mind joining me? Would you mind joining me? Yes. Get a big round of applause. Thank you. Thank you so much. Sorry to disturb you there as you were taking notes. Hello, what's your name?
Gunilla.
Gunilla, where are you from?
I'm from Belgium.
You're from?
The name is Swedish.
The name is Swedish, but you're from Belgium?
Yes.
Yes, and you just came over for this conference?
Yes, indeed.
Oh, fantastic. Fantastic. Gunilla, what I want you to do is just think of a very, very special moment in your life.
With my eyes closed.
With your eyes open, it's good. You know the film Titanic? Where they stand at the very front of the ship and he says, I'm the king of the world. This kind of moment, where you felt really, really good. And excited and very special. Yes, you got one? Did you see the eyes weren't down? Okay. So the emotion is there, very good. Whenever I ask these kind of questions, I know that people know when this happened on that particular day, if it was noon in the afternoon or at night. Without saying it, do you know that? Approximately. So you have a rough time in your head. Yes. Like, but a full hour, like 10 or 12. You have. It's a full hour, not a very specific time, like 13:23 or something. Spot on, yes? But what I want you to do, because this was a very special moment, what I want you to do is just make it a very special time as well. So if you'd like to add some minutes to it or subtract some minutes, yeah, whatever you want, okay? So it's not a full hour, I mean, that would be too easy. Not anymore, perfect. Gunilla, we haven't prearranged anything, huh? No, we didn't set anything up? Nothing at all, no. So you are not just saying yes to everything I say, and just write it down here, okay? The hour and the minutes, please. Okay, in the meantime, I'd like to borrow a watch from somebody. Just, and is it possible to turn your hands?
Yes.
Yeah? Perfect. Wonderful. Great, and thank you. And I need a lady with a purse. Would you mind? You have a big handbag, okay. Whatever you want, I don't care. We can just use it, and I'm going to use that one. If we put it in, are we going to find it again?
Yes.
Okay, I just need to ask, there were some incidents. Okay, excellent. What I want you to do, and what I found out was that it's been the easiest way to read somebody's mind if they visualize. Okay, what I want you to do is just in your mind, well, we are in London, so you can picture yourself in front of Big Ben, if you like. Yes, there was a good picture, double the size of it. Okay, as you look at it. Very good, very good. And then just concentrate on the hour hand, would you? Okay, and let it turn and turn and then become slower and slower. And then it stops at your particular hour. And just think, is it day or night? That would be great. Thank you. And now what I want you to do is just concentrate on the minute hand. Okay, let it rotate and rotate. And you already done that, yes? You're already there. It was very quick. Can you do that again? Yeah. I have no idea what this makes sense at all, what I'm writing down, but we'll find out in a second. And Sandra, would you mind helping us? You can leave that there. Just help us here on stage, please. That would be great. Sandra, everybody. Sandra, you are the eyes and ears of the whole audience. You can see everything up close, so if I turn here, you can see the hands are really moving, yes? Yeah, is that correct?
That's correct.
That's correct, which means I haven't given you this watch before. It's really a watch, okay. I don't want to know where to start, Sandra, okay? So what I want you to do is just take it in your right hand, left hand, sorry. Yeah, just like that, it'll be easier. And just turn the crown, yes? Which direction I leave it up to you, okay? What I want you to do is just concentrate on that image that you just had in mind of that time. Make it as bright and vivid as you possibly can, as clear, okay? Look each other into your eyes, and you can stop whenever you want, okay? Do this now. Here? Would you like to go further, or would you like to stop here? It's okay? Good. Let's just press it in. And just hold it in your hands, like that. Okay? Perfect. Anthony was going like this. Okay. Gunilla, sometimes I am spot on what I do, and I don't know, sometimes not really. I don't know. Somehow I have difficulties with you. I don't know. But can you tell what kind of memory you had? What kind of memory? Or is it too personal?
It's quite personal.
It's quite personal. I thought so, yes. Then keep it to yourself, okay? So only we know. And what I want you to do now is just... what I want you to do now is just say out loud, as loud as you can, the time you were thinking of.
2:32 p.m.
So it's 14:32.
Yes.
14:32.
Belgium time.
In Belgium time, 14:32. So much, that's my job. With you, I have no control whatsoever. Yes, it's your watch. You turn the hand, you stop whenever you like. Yes, where did you stop? You need to speak to him. Okay, just take a look. What is that?
Oh my gosh.
Can you say that loud?
Yes, it's
2:33. 2:33? Well, spot on. Almost spot on, exactly time. Yes, exact the time. Exact the time. Yes, give those ladies a big round of applause. Sensational. Thank you so much. Thank you so very much indeed. And thank you very much. So, yes, that's been my talk. I have to say, it's been such a pleasure and a privilege to be speaking with you here today. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you'd like, let's stay in contact on Facebook or wherever. Just email me. And yeah, I'm Harry Lucas. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you.